Hey guys, so this is my Merrow Machine Co. 18-E. It's a single thread crochet stitch industrial machine. It's basically the most highly specialized machine I have. It's designed to do a decorative crochet stitch that appears like a hand stitch around the edge of like blankets or knit goods or whatnot. It's a clean and quick way to finish like a fleece blanket or something. So I wasn't looking for this machine necessarily. I ran across it. My wife saw what it was capable of and really wanted it. So I went and picked it up. And it's actually a pretty cool little machine. I don't use it that much really, but my wife's used it a few times and for some projects and has really enjoyed it. It uses a size 5 yarn, so a 5/2 yarn with a large needle and a hook. And the machine itself is little. You can see it's pretty small. If you're familiar with the Wilcox and Gibbs chain stitch machine, you can see it for size comparison. And this white section here, this is basically the size of a cutout for a standard industrial machine. So it's literally half the size. It's pretty small. But because of that, it's kind of a challenge to set up on a table. Now, Merrow offers a couple options. One is a full-size table like this one that just has a cutout basically for the belt and then also for a chain for the presser foot lift, which is foot-operated. The other option, they make a custom cart basically that is a little bit larger than the dimensions of the machine. It's portable. It's on wheels. It's a pretty cool option, actually. But they start at like $600, so it wasn't realistic. I could build something for much less. But I didn't even want to have a standalone table because we don't use the machine that frequently, so I couldn't justify it. So I wanted to adapt it for use in my table. So this isn't the industrial table that I built. I welded the legs and made the top. It's a walnut butcher block top that I use basically all my industrials in. And swap them out. So I wanted to figure out how I could adapt this table to use this machine on it without much effort to convert it over. So this is basically what I came up with. I thought I'd just show you this setup and then I'll show you how the machine sews. And the reason why I want to show you too is because you can do the same thing. Let's say you have a Wilcox and Gibbs or something. You can use a smaller belt size because you have to. This is for a small 3/16 inch belt, but I could use the same principle here and adapt it and use my Wilcox and Gibbs on a table like this, which I might do actually, because that Wilcox is a fun machine too. But anyway, what it is I took the dimensions of the cutout for the table, cut up some melamine that I just had in the garage. I'll probably redo this later when I have an opportunity to pick up some actual walnut and just make the whole thing out of walnut. But I just used some scrap melamine that I had, and then I just edge banded it with some scraps of walnut that I had, so to just cover up those edges. And this is a 1/2 inch larger in each direction than the cutout. And all I did was, after I put the edge banding on, I went and lined the machine up to make sure that it was parallel to the front edge of the table. And I clamped it in place, and then on the underside, I just took some scraps and I tacked in all these little scraps that I had cut up. These are poplar, and then the end pieces I think are maple. Just whatever I had. You can see it's wood's dirty, and you know, just what I had. So tacked it in place with some brad nails to make sure it was a tight fit, and then went and countersunk and screwed it on. So all you have to do basically is just line it up, drop it in. And then for the belt uses a lot smaller belt. Normally I use a 42 belt on here, or 41 maybe. This one uses a 34. So all I do is just slip the belt on, loosen the screws on the underside, and then tighten them down just by hand. You don't need a whole lot of tension on these things. And then that's it. And then now this machine's ready to go. The only other thing is that it needs to rotate away from you as opposed to towards you like most machines. And that's what's great about having a servo motor like this Enduro, where you can switch the direction that the machine turns just on a setting. So it's not like on a clutch where you have to rewire it. So it makes it easy to switch back and forth between the machines. So that's it. And then the machine's ready to go. I can use it. So I have a scrap here. I was sewing it so you can see what the stitches look like. It's pretty cool. It's pretty unique. And I just thought I'd do a little video on it so you can see what I can do. Sorry for all the movement here. I'm trying to figure out the best way to do this. Maybe like that. And the machine, it's not really designed to be run that fast. So 1,000 stitches per inch is what it should run at. So here's a little piece that I already done. This is the bottom, and then that's the top. And Merrow actually is a company that invented the overlock machine, you know, over 100 years ago. So I don't have the chain set up, so you have to push on the back here to get the presser foot to raise, which is no big deal. So, I didn't need the foot. We're not doing a lot of production work, so it's not really a big thing for us. So, push it down, drop it in. I'm kind of in an awkward position here, so I'm going to see if I can try to look through the camera and do it. So, also on this, you want to do rounded edges. It just makes it a lot easier, but... And the stitch length on this is adjustable between 3/8 of an inch and a half inch. So, I kind of butchered that corner right there, but it's kind of hard to do this. From the side of the machine as opposed to in front of it. So, let me zoom out so you can see what it looks like. So this is what the edge looks like. So this is the top. You have this V stitch. You can see the edges there are finished. And this is two layers of fleece. And so you can't really see that that exposed edge. And then on the bottom, which is really cool, you get this finished these parallel stitches. It looks like a hand stitch. So you can see that this edge looks quite a bit better than this one, which I muddled up. But, that's pretty much what you can expect going around a corner, depending on the radius too. So, see, it's a cool way to finish it, and it's quick. And the thing about it too is this is a flexible stitch, so you can use it on... You know, it's really stretchy, so you don't have to worry about breaking this stitch. Plus, it's thick yarn, and it's quick. So you could just take two layers of any material. I might make like a blanket like this, and use like canvas on one side, and then use like a fleece on the other. You can make like a picnic or beach blanket. There are a lot of options for this, and then you can get different colors. The stitch length on it varies. Stock is 4 stitches per inch. And you can't adjust the stitch length with, there's no adjustment like on a normal machine. You have to change out a part. I mean, I was looking for it here, I just found it. So you have to change out a cam here. Here's one, this is the 4 stitches per inch cam that's found on the underside of the machine. So there's that cam under there. So you have to change that out, and you can change it from stock is 4 stitches per inch, which is a pretty good spacing. And you can go all the way as tight as 10 stitches per inch. So it's really, really, really close. I actually ordered, we have 6 stitches per inch and 8 stitches per inch, double this in closeness, but they don't fit on the machine. So I need to contact Merrow and see why. This machine is a 99, so it's 15 years old. I don't know if they changed the design, but you can see this cutout right in here. It's keyed, so that way you don't have to worry about adjustment. This is consistent every time if you go to take it out. And actually, that's this case with a lot of the parts on this machine. Everything's marked, or so you don't have to. You can take it apart and put it back together. And you don't have to worry about timing and whatnot. And timing, it's easy anyway. But this is really a well thought out machine. They paid a lot of attention to details on this, and it's really impressive. Like, just the finish on this and the machining on all the parts and the tolerances. It's really, really impressive. Merrow is really, they've produced some really impressive machines. I'm actually on the lookout for one of their overlock machines that I want. But anyway, so back to the stitch length. The cutout here, this keyway, is on my machine is tall. You can see how tall that keyway is. On the new ones that I ordered, the whole size is the same, but the keyway is only half the height. So it doesn't fit on this machine, so we can't change the stitch length. Now, I'm going to contact them. I don't know what the answer is. Maybe there's a different model that I need to order, or I might have to modify this machine. I almost started to modify the machine. I almost started filing down the keyway to get it to fit, but I don't really want to modify a machine, especially something this high quality, where parts, you know, they have parts. And the thing that's impressive too about Merrow is that they have parts all the way back to 1925, and they're stocking them. So, I mean, that's wild. You know, find a machine from 1930 and then be able to get a replacement part from them new is pretty cool. So, something to keep in mind if you're looking at some older used ones. Like I said, this one's only 15 years old, so it's by no means a vintage machine. But if you do run across an older one, you know, the design hasn't necessarily changed that much. So, yeah. So there it is, that's the Merrow 18E crochet stitch machine for finishing edges on blankets and whatnot. So, just thought I'd share. It's kind of a more unique setup. So, let me know if you have any questions. Thanks, guys.